Breaking right now, we know exactly how much money Oklahoma political candidates have. Tonight in Commitment 2010, Eyewitness News 5's Mark Opgrande is tracking the money trail exactly 1 week from the primaries. He's live at the state capitol tonight. Mark?
Yeah, that's right, Jessica. In fact, the groups, the candidates who are vying for that office right back there, they're spending big money to get there. In the race for the state's top spot, the governor's office, the candidates have racked up quite the war chest. The latest numbers from the state election board show Mary Fallon in the lead. Between April and July, Fallon raised $743,000 and spent $747,000. She also has $742,000 on hand. Drew Edmondson came in second. He raised $466,000. His campaign spent $798,000 with $800,000 left. Jerry Askin raised $214,000. She spent $890,000 and has just over $500,000 left. She also gave her campaign a $675,000 loan. Randy Brogdon, he raised $164,000, spent nearly $150,000 and has $77,000 left. This year's fundraising efforts by candidates for governor are also ones for the record books. Drew Edmondson has received the fifth highest campaign dollars in state history, $2.5 million. Mary Fallon comes in sixth with $2.4 million, and Askins is in seventh. Brad Henry's 2006 campaign is the highest in state history, racking up a whopping $4.8 million. And in fact, there's still only 3 months left until the election, so it's a good bet that either who the Republican or the Democratic nominees are for the governor's office has a good chance of passing Brad Henry. We're live. Mark Opgrande, Eyewitness News 5.
Thanks, Mark. Now, two other Republican candidates for governor, Robert Hubbard and Roger Jackson, raised just over a combined $5,000 between April and July.